Let's open our Bibles tonight to Exodus chapter 1, verses 15 to 20. Exodus chapter 1, verses 15 to 20. Hallelujah.
Then the king of Egypt spoke to the Hebrew midwives, of whom the name of one was Sephora and the name of the other Puah. And he said, when you do the duties of a midwife for the Hebrew women and see them on the birth stools, if it is a son, then you shall kill him. But if it's a daughter, then she shall live. But the midwives feared God and did not do as the king of Egypt commanded them, but saved the male children alive. So the king of Egypt called for the midwives and said to them, why have you done this thing and saved the male children alive? And the midwives said to Pharaoh, because the Hebrew women are not like the Egyptian women, for they are lively and give birth before the midwives come to them. Therefore God dealt with the midwives, and the people multiplied and grew very mighty.
Amen. Hallelujah. Tonight the Lord asked me to minister from these scriptures, and I pray that the Holy Spirit will make us a strategic church. This word is going to release you into a strategic anointing. Hallelujah. If you want to title this words, you can title it the midwives in the church. Hallelujah. If you want to have a complicated word, you can put Hamliale anointing. Praise God. Hallelujah. The midwives in the church, that word comes from the Hebrew word Hamliale. What is this anointing over our lives? We've been hearing about the anointing of God in the past few weeks. What is this anointing? This is something the Lord gave me a couple of years back, and I just opened the book, and today, and the Holy Spirit inspired me to give you this tonight. Hallelujah. Who are the midwives in the church? The midwives, it's there in the word, mid, the one who stands in the middle. How many of you want to stand in the middle? Hallelujah. We need to have a shift in our lives. We need to stand in the middle. Hallelujah. Between God and people. We want to stand in the middle, protecting the assignment of God. Who were the midwives? There were people who stood in the middle between God and God's purpose fulfilling. Hallelujah. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Even tonight, you should have a grace to say, Lord, I will stand in the middle. By the end of this talk, we will connect this talk to the financial blessing. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But I'm starting from this. A midwife. The word wife means itself covenant. In other words, one who has covenanted with God to stand and pray to see God's plans and purposes to fulfillment. Hallelujah. The one who has covenanted with God to pray. Like Anna in the New Testament, she prayed day and night, the Bible says, in the temple. One who has covenanted to carry the burdens of the Lord in the presence of the Lord on behalf of God. Praise the Lord. There's a difference tonight. When the shift comes, it is not just behalf of people. One who has covenanted with God to carry the burdens of God on behalf of God. Hallelujah. So that God's breakthrough will be released. Hallelujah. In the appointed time of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hamliale. We want to ask the Lord for this anointing. Hallelujah. The people who stand in the middle. When you stand praying. Hallelujah. For somebody on behalf of God. Hallelujah. Today when we look at it in our lives too. If we stand in the middle, hallelujah, to pray for our husbands and our wives, hallelujah, itself, there will be divine breakthroughs. I don't know how many of you have habitually praying for your husbands and your wives. Amen. It's a divine. It is God's purpose that it's God's plan. It is God's desire. It's God's burden that you start praying for your family. It's God's plan that you start praying for the church. It's God's plan. It's God's burden that you carry the man of God in prayer. It is God's burden to carry the people and the leadership and their families in prayer. It's God's, hallelujah, desire. It's God's burden. That's why somebody came against Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. It was not people who came and said, hey, Moses is our leader. Don't speak against him. It was God. It was God's servant. God came in between. So it is God's burden that you carry the man of God who prays for you. Hallelujah. Amen. The greatest asset of God in any church are the midwives. The people who have entered a covenant with God that they will stand in the middle between God and an assignment. Praise the Lord. Moses was God's assignment. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Moses was God's assignment. It was the midwives. It was the people who were standing in the middle who protected that assignment. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The church has an assignment in the city. There are people God is using to fulfill that assignment. And God, the greatest asset in any church is the midwives, the one who stand in the middle. Not just interceding, but carrying the assignment of God. Who understands it. Hallelujah. Amen. Moses was God's assignment to Israel. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Are you with me, church? And the midwives protected God's assignment by standing in the middle. What happened? When the midwives protected, the Lamb of God was revealed. Jesus, the Lamb of God, was revealed. When the midwives stood in the middle, revival was released after 400 years. Isn't it amazing? It took the midwives, hallelujah, praise the Lord, to stir up the revival. നടക്കുന്നതെന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്ന ദൈവമക്കൾക്കായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം പറയുന്നു. മോശേനെ ആ പ്രാർത്ഥനയിൽ കാക്കുന്ന ദൈവമക്കൾക്കായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം പറയുന്നു. ദൈവത്തിന്റെ പദ്ധതിയും പ്ലാനെയും പ്രാർത്ഥനയിൽ ചുമക്കുന്ന ദൈവമക്കൾക്കായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം പറയുന്നു. അതൊരു അഭിഷേകമാണ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ബിഫോർ എവറി റിവൈവൽ, കാർലസ് അനക്കോണ്ട, അർജന്റീനിയൻ മാൻ ഓഫ് ഗോഡ്, ഹു ഗോഡ് റിലീസ് ഗ്രേറ്റ് റിവൈവൽസ് ഇൻ ദോസ് സിറ്റി. ബിഫോർ കാർലസ് അനക്കോണ്ട വുൾ As he would preach through the pulpit, there was a team that would stay praying for him, and all the demonic people who are possessed by demons will be just thrown out into this particular tent where his intercession team would be there. And while he is preaching, hallelujah, these people who are in the tent, who are intercessors, and when you bring these people into this tent, people will immediately be supernaturally delivered. I am praying tonight, God will raise up intercessors, those kind of people. You don't need somebody to go, hallelujah, you are so unison, hallelujah, or with the purpose of God, that hallelujah, your very presence, hallelujah, will make the enemy exit. Revival starts with these kind of people. Revival cannot move forward without midwives in the church. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It is not because of the lack of gifting. Sometimes revival stops. It is because of the lack of intercession. Praise the Lord. ഉണർവ് ചിലപ്പോൾ സംഭവിക്കാതിരിക്കുന്നത്, ഹല്ലേലൂയ, കൃപാവരം ഇല്ലാഞ്ഞിട്ടല്ല, ഭാഷാവരം ഇല്ലാഞ്ഞിട്ടല്ല, പ്രാർത്ഥന ഇല്ലാഞ്ഞിട്ടാ. പ്രൈസ് ദ ലോർഡ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ഇടയ്ക്ക് നിന്ന് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാൻ, മധ്യസ്ഥം വഹിക്കാൻ ആരും ഇല്ലാഞ്ഞിട്ടാ. ദ ലോർഡ് ഹിംസെൽഫ് സെഡ്, ഐ ആം ലുക്കിംഗ് ഫോർ സംബഡി ടു സ്റ്റാൻഡ് ദ ഗ്യാപ്. Even the Lord's cry, hallelujah, was looking always to look somebody to stand at the gap. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Revival was revealed. Exodus was revealed. Hallelujah. Direction was revealed. All because of the midwives. Isn't it amazing? 4 generations of curse, drought, slavery, everything was over. Praise the Lord. Because of this midwives who stood in the middle and protected Moses. Hallelujah. Everybody say midwives. People in the middle. Even today, it is the midwives that has protected this message from coming to you. Behind this message, there are people who have prayed. It is the midwives, even today, as we are speaking, there are people who are standing in the middle for President Trump in the United States. So that, not because he's perfect, because at least he's following the plan and agenda of God. Praise the Lord. There are people who are praying that the president of the United States will make decisions that will glorify the Lord. Hallelujah. When people are trying to take 10 commandments from school, when people are trying to bring all sort of things against the word of God, there are people in the nation of America, so is in India. There is a group of people that some of us are able to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. In the freedom and the liberty of the Holy Spirit. It's because there is people in India who is praying for us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I heard about just a story just a couple of days back about a pastor's daughter being raped in front of him because he preached the gospel. Hallelujah. Imagine the plight which that family is going through. And here we are in a beautiful space, able to worship the Lord with free freedom and liberty. And this pastor and this family, hallelujah, amidst all these trials and persecutions, did not quit. They are still following the Lord even today. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Here is my thing. We are able to have a worship, hallelujah, twice a week, able to worship the Lord, hallelujah, given an opportunity, hallelujah. It is because there is somebody who is praying, hallelujah. There are midwives who are praying, there are intercessors who are praying, hallelujah, and protecting us, hallelujah, so that we will come here and listen to the word of God. If you are here tonight, it is because behind that, somebody prayed for you, hallelujah. Thank the Lord for that person tonight. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Other day when I got up in the morning, it just came through my mouth. I have this habit when I get up in the morning, I just apply the blood of Jesus Christ upon my family, my in-laws, my co-sisters, my brother-in-laws, their family, their business, our work, church, people, everybody. A few days back, it just came out as I was praying that every premature death, every untimely death be broken in the name of Jesus. And immediately, a couple of hours later, I got a phone call saying that the kid was in danger and the Lord supernaturally somehow brought him through. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. What I want to try to tell you tonight, hallelujah, every time something happens to you and it evades your life, it's because there is somebody God uses, hallelujah, somewhere, hallelujah, in the church to pray for you tonight. Hallelujah. Are you with me, church? These are the people who protect the church from the wolves and the Jezebels. If you have a good intercession team, no Jezebel spirit can ever have power. No control. Hallelujah. Madhyastham vahikkunna oru sabha undengil, hallelujah. Jezebel varathilla. Chennai varathilla. Kurukkam varathilla. Praise the Lord. Kooyittu ponda vazhi vekkolum. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Because every time, God raises up something, the devil also will raise up something. And it is a clear sign there is a battle. And a clear sign a victory will come. God raised up Moses, devil raised up Pharaoh. God raised up David, and devil raised up Goliath. God raised up Jesus, the devil raised up Herod to kill him. Every time God raises up something, hallelujah. But praise be to God. That's why we need to pray together. Pray for each other. Because if you stand together, pray for each other. Hallelujah. Pharaoh will leave. Horse and the rider will be cast out into the sea. Hallelujah. Glory. The Goliath will be killed with the stone of you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Power. Amen. Hallelujah. We need to be midwives. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Some of their characteristics. Number one. They are door openers. Madhyastham thin edakki nikkunnavar vaadil thorakkukara vaadil thorakkunnavara. They open the door for Moses. Even the greatest prophet needed a simple midwife to open a door. First time pastor went to Malawi to preach the gospel. God used a man called somebody who was the most backsliding person in the church. Who was, I think I've told you this example many a time. He was the most backslidden, more troublesome person in the church. He went to the nation for some work. He ended up being in a church and the pastors were praying together like this. And one of the pastors, main pastors, felt the Holy Spirit telling, ask that boy who's sitting there to preach. And he preached the word. And it was so powerful, they thought he's a pastor, a man of God, a prophet. So he said, who are you? Are you a pastor? And he said, I'm not a pastor, I'm the backbencher. I am one of those who keeps troubling pastors. I'm the troubler in the church. And then they thought, if the troubler in the church could preach such good word, how much will be his pastor? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That is how, what I'm trying to tell you tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. They have this anointing. It is not just a grace. It is an anointing of God. It is not something that comes when you pray. It is an anointing. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You might not be having the best days, but there is a door opener into your hearts. Paul said, pray for me that an effective door shall be opened. Hallelujah. Glory to God. There are door openers sitting here. You might be the most simple. You might be the most unknown person in the church. The unknowns will open the door because there is an anointing. Hallelujah. Called, hallelujah, humbly lay anointing. You will open the door. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Never underestimate anybody because they had a weak day. Hallelujah. Even the smallest of the people are doorkeepers. Hallelujah. A doorkeeper in the house of the Lord is better than the tents of the wicked. Hallelujah. A doorkeeper is also a door opener. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You will think that an insignificant, I'm a doorkeeper. Praise the Lord. Standing at the back. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I remember a few years back, there was one person who I asked them to be usher. The first time ushering. There was a family who was coming to the church and they was not feeling connected. And this person who was ushering would never able to talk and express. He was not a people's man or, not somebody who would talk much. Just once I asked, just say hello to somebody. He said hello and this people felt so belong to the church. What am I trying to say tonight? Even some of you are the weakest and some of you said, I'm not talented enough. Your smile might be a door opener. Praise the Lord. For somebody else. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The woman who touched the hem of the garment. After that woman, everybody went and touched the hem of the garment. Praise the Lord. This woman who was unnamed, who did not have a name, could open a door. You and I can open a door for the glory of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. A doorkeeper in the house of the Lord is better than in the tents of the wicked. A doorkeeper is passionate about Jesus and his church. And he will bypass his ego just to be a doorkeeper. How many of us will bypass an ego just to be a doorkeeper? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's why I like the school of Pastor Rajesh. I trained in the school of Pastor Rajesh. One pastor asked me, whose school are you trained? I said, the school of Pastor Rajesh. Every ego will leave your life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Be alert, teach to be a doorkeeper. Teach to stand behind. Teach to do everything. Praise the Lord. Teach you to, hallelujah, minister even if you don't have a mic in your hands. Hallelujah. You might not have an important place in the eyes of the people, but you are anointed in the eyes of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. നീ മനുഷ്യരെ നോക്കുമ്പോൾ അവിടെ ഒരു സ്ഥാനവും ഇല്ല. എന്നാൽ ദൈവം നിനക്ക് അഭിഷക്തമായ അഭിഷേകമുള്ള ഒരു സ്ഥാനം നിന്നെ ഏൽപ്പിച്ചിരിക്കുകയാണ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ആമേൻ. ദേ ആർ ഡോർ ഓപ്പണേഴ്സ്. നമ്പർ 2. ആർ യു ഹിയർ ടുനൈറ്റ്? ആം ഐ ടു ഫാസ്റ്റ് ടുനൈറ്റ്? ദേ ആർ നോട്ട് ഓൺലി ഡോർ ഓപ്പണേഴ്സ്, ദേ ആർ അനോയിന്റഡ് ലിസണേഴ്സ്. ആമേൻ. Look at these people. Who are the midwives? The people who stood at the middle. They either would have had experiences from the Lord. They would have heard about the God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph. And they would have said, we want to experience the God of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph. The Bible says, Pharaoh forgot Joseph. And the next Pharaoh came, he forgot Joseph. But the midwives did not. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. They were listeners. What they heard about the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob never left their life. Some of you had a financial 10 days. Somebody said, Pastor, it was like a retreat. Praise God. 10 days. So calmly and so smoothly it went. But did you listen? Is anything that you heard is part of your lives even tonight? Hallelujah. Are you still going through it and prophesying it over your life? Then you should be an anointed listener. An anointed listener is the one who's spoken about in Psalm 34. He who trusts in the Lord shall never be put to shame. Praise the Lord. He's a listener. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Not only they were anointed listeners, they feared the Lord, the Bible says. I want you to take a scriptures. Psalm 34 and the 11th verse. Psalm 34 and the 11th verse.
Come, you children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord.
Come, you children, listen to me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. The anointed listeners have a reverential awe of God. They fear the Lord. Praise the Lord. The anointed children, they listen to me. Why? Because they fear God. They want to learn to be more of awe of God. Hallelujah. They want to be in awe of. They don't want to just listen. They want to experience what they listened. Hallelujah. It is when you listen that you become in awe. People have become, church has become usual. Church has become boring. Church has become a mundane. Is it because, you know why? Church is no longer what you it was to you when you came for the first time, when you had the first love, when you were so excited to come. Praise the Lord. You know why? Because you lost the awe of God. Because you lost the art of listening. Tonight, I rebuke every empty thoughts from your life. Every vain thoughts from your life. Every vain things that you are hearing that does not have any weight. You need to hear the voice of the Lord. Come, you children, for what? Listen to me. I will teach you the awe of God. Wow. This woman, women, hallelujah, had an awe of God because they were anointed listeners. Abraham was an anointed listener. Hallelujah. Who is an anointed listener? He's not perfect, but they have listened to God more times than they have listened to the devil. Praise the Lord. I always like to be practical. Just because anointed listener does not mean that you have not heard and followed the devil once or twice. You would have. Even Abraham did. Praise the Lord. They listened to more than they listened to their wives. Praise the Lord. Some of you would have listened to the wives once or twice. That's okay. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. Praise God. Hallelujah. Husbands would have only heard, sometimes it's bad. I said, sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. Sometimes it's good also. Hallelujah. Abraham have listened to God, but he's made a mistake in our life. Everybody has a Hagar. Everybody has a Hagar. Or Hagar. A fleshy mistake. A fleshy mistake. Every person have come. Because you listen to the wrong voice. A fleshy voice. Have committed fleshy mistakes. But you cannot stay there. Nee pishasinde aayirikkam. Jadigamayitta. Logathinte vaakkukal ketta. Nee jadigamaya mohangalil veenittundayirikkam. Everybody would have done that. But bring it under the blood. Amen. And cast that bondage out of your house. Let the blood helps you, strengthens you, forgives you to cast the bondage and every wickedness out of the house. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Flesh, you allow, it will take your peace and your life out of you. In Romans chapter 8 and the 6th verse. Romans, if you walk in the flesh, if you listen to the flesh, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. So when you're spirit-led, spirit-filled, it is life and it's peace. So if there is no life, if there is no peace, you are walking in the flesh. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Are you with me, church? As a Christian, you have to have authority over the flesh. Look at somebody and say, have authority over the flesh. A fleshy mistake, sudden anger, a fleshy mistake, sudden burst. The flesh. Hallelujah. The second example, Abraham, though he listened to, he had a Hagar in his life. He had a Hagar in his life, but not always. Praise the Lord. The moment Hagar left, everything began to change. Hallelujah. A supernatural change comes when the flesh leaves. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, somebody. Jadam maripoombol, adishega maramaya, or avasarangal, namaka kartavu terium. There will be purposes. Hallelujah. We'll be purposeful. Hallelujah. We will be given opportunities in the spirit. Number two. Isaac listened to God when he was tied on the altar. When Abraham heard, listen to me tonight, some of you is going to be a prophetic word. When Abraham tied him on the altar, just before those few seconds where Abraham was going to take the knife and was going to kill him, an angel of the Lord appeared. Hallelujah. How many of you here was in that kind of a situation? If Isaac would not have listened, he could have slapped his father and would have said, don't you know it's 21st century? You are tying me on the altar? Your few seconds between death and life are in the hands of God and not in the hands of the devil. Hallelujah. Your few minutes, if you are a listener to God, if you listen to Jesus, and if you obey Him, your seconds, the few seconds between death and life, between poverty and rich, hallelujah, fly in the hands of God and not in the hands of the devil. How many of you believe that tonight in the name of the Lord? If you are a listener, hallelujah, he listened to God and worshiped. Those precious few seconds of your life tonight. Hallelujah. Marnathinum jeevathinum edireyulla idayulla aa cheriya seconds pishasinte hallelujah nedirthathilalla nadakkunnathu devathinte swargathile nedirthathinte adilana. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There's a man of God called John Hagee. While he was preaching once again, I mean in a church, there was a man who came with a gun and pointed towards him and shot at him 6 times. Man of God did not die, because when the person who shot the man of God, he saw the bullets, 3 going to this side and 3 piercing on that side of the wall, because amidst the midst of the shooter and John Hagee was the angel of God. He took his wing, one here, one there, one here, one there, one here, one there. Between death and life, the few seconds belongs, hallelujah, not to the devil, but to the hands of God. Somebody here tonight. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Pastor, the first time he was preaching in Ranchi, if my memory is right, there was thousands of people there. There were protection kept there, but one of the police officers allowed one person to go into the camp and to make a plot to kill Pastor. He came with a belt around him, you've seen those belts, like those Indian belts that can kill people as sharp as a sword. So he came near, he was going to attack Pastor, and the praise was so loud and so anointed that the thing that was between his waist broke down into two pieces. Between life and death, the few seconds. Hallelujah, does not belong to the devil. If you are a listener, if you are obeyed God, if you worship the Lord, let me have a good news for you tonight. There is nothing to fear. Hallelujah, glory to God. Third example tonight. Look at Jacob. He was running away from Esau. God chose Jacob. Why? Because Jacob was a listener. Between his ego and between the enemy, he chose to leave ego. On one side was Jacob's ego, and on the other side was the enemy. I am amazed in the church. Some people still choose their ego and get belted by the enemy. I'm amazed. Hallelujah. Ego means edging God out. After listening to words years and years, your ego is more important. And I've seen people belted by the enemy, belted by the devil. And they come with the most ridiculous excuse, Pastor, you would not pray for me. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But Jacob was a smart man. He was a cheater, but a smart man. He was a deceiver, but a smart man. He chose to put down his ego and stop wrestling with God. And he said, Lord, I'm Jacob. Lord, I'm Jacob. I need help. I'm a man. You are God. I need help, Lord. You are up. I am down. I need help, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You are strong. I'm weak. Hallelujah. I need help. And then God said, you are no longer Jacob, but I'm making you a prince. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When you put down your ego, God will lift you up. Hallelujah. Somebody here tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That's why God said, I will call myself the God of Jacob. He said, I'm going to change. Historically, he who should have been the God of Esau, he said, I'm going to change it. I'm going to be known as the God of Jacob because he listened to me. He wrestled with me, but he listened to me. Some of you are going through wrestlings, private wrestlings, secret wrestlings. Better put down your ego, son. Put down your ego, daughter, and look to the Lord and say, transform me, Lord. Bless me into transformation. Fourth example was Joseph. He chose to listen to God and saw his dreams come to pass. There is any listeners here, write it in your book. If you are a listener, nee, hallelujah, devathinte shabdam kekkunnavanaanengil ninde swapnam, hallelujah, will come to pass. And sakshka adinoru hallelujah, praise the Lord, come to fulfillment. The listeners saw the dreams coming to fulfillment, what the devil tried to destroy. Praise the Lord. There are dreams that the devil has chosen to destroy, but to be a listener, it will come to fulfillment. Hallelujah. Next example, number five, Rahab. Listen to God. How? Through the anointed servant. Sometimes God speaks to men of God. She was a prostitute. She did not know how to hear the voice of God. But she heard the voice through the spies who came. And from a prostitute and from an address of Jericho, the most popular prostitute address. The most unclean place where thieves were born, according to the Bible, where blind people were there, according to the Bible, where killers and murderers were there, according to the Bible, where uncleanness was a lifestyle. From the address of a prostitute, her address changed into great grandmother of Jesus. Ah. Praise the Lord. Greatness is not an accident. Greatness is because for the listeners. Kekkunnavanana. Hallelujah. It is for the listeners, the greatness of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. How many of you want the address to change tonight? Hallelujah. Look at the next example. Who listened? Bathsheba. Bathsheba, by listening to Solomon, listening to David, after she sinned, became a woman of God. Bathsheba had two. When she did not listen, she committed adultery. She listened to the fleshy David, she became an adulteress. She listened to the spirit-filled David, she became a woman of God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Always listen to the spirit-filled counsel. Praise the Lord. Just because somebody is a prophet, hallelujah, somebody has a tag, somebody just comes out of nowhere and prophesies, don't listen. There are fleshy counsels, there are spiritual counsels. Praise the Lord. ഏതെങ്കിലും പ്രവാചകൻ വന്നിട്ട് എന്തെങ്കിലും മണ്ടത്തരം പറഞ്ഞ് കേൾക്കരുത്. പ്രൈസ് ദ ലോർഡ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. സ്പിരിറ്റ് ഫിൽഡ് ഡേവിഡ് മേഡ് ഹർ ഇൻടു എ വുമൺ ഓഫ് ഗോഡ്. ആർ യു ഹിയർ ടുനൈറ്റ്? ആർ യു ഹിയർ ടുനൈറ്റ്? ചർച്ച്, ലിസൺ. റൂത്ത് ലിസൺ ടു ബോവസ് ആൻഡ് നയോമി, ആൻഡ് ഷീ നെവർ ഹാഡ് ടു റിമെമ്പർ ഹർ കേഴ്സസ് അഗൈൻ. കേഴ്സ്ഡ് ലെവർ. She was recommended to the highest post. The Lord prophetically asked me to tell you, somebody, you listeners, God is going to recommend to something of the highest post. Hallelujah, for the glory of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Receive it tonight. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. Receive it in the... Rabadios paladara duradara vara sandara. We give you praise. Receive it, Lord. Even Samuel became the greatest prophet by listening to God through the voice of Eli. Samuel did not become the prophet just on the, you know, just because God chose him. He listened to the voice of God through the voice of Eli. When God called Samuel, Samuel, who did Samuel run to? To Eli. Why? He heard the voice of God in the voice of Eli. If God can use a backslidden prophet, a backslidden man to raise up a prophet, come on. Come on, somebody, tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Do you think the fivefold ministry God has given, hallelujah, the pastors who stand in the gap between God, hallelujah, and preaching the feeding you with the word of God, will not God act through their lives? Submit to the church. Submit to the leadership. Submit to what is being told to you and see what God will do for you. Hallelujah. I remember a girl who was waiting for a marriage for a long, long time, and was nothing was happening, and it was this instruction just out of the blue, ignited by the Spirit of God, and I told her very, very simple instruction. All I told her was to comb her hair. It's not that she was not combing. I said, comb in a particular, in a well-mannered, because you're a child of God. In a month's time, she got married to one of the best boys I know. Hallelujah. It's not about combing her. It's about listening to the instructions. It's listening, submitting when it is spoken. Even the stupidest thing will turn it to be a blessing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So some of you, that was instruction for her. Some of you will get another instruction. Hallelujah. Elisha washing the hands of Elijah. Only time he would hear Elijah speaking well is when he washes his hands. Otherwise, Elijah, I think otherwise is a very fiery man. Only when he's hungry, he would peacefully speak. But he received. And he reached a place where with his intelligence and with his money, he would have never reached. Hallelujah. He connected to heavenly mandates, impartations, double portions. Hallelujah. All because there was a listener in him. Mary walked in high favor, because she listened to the angel. Simple. Are you with me, church? John 8:29 is a powerful words. And read John 29. The 10th example is Jesus himself.
And he who sent me is with me. The Father has not left me alone, for I always do those things that please him.
Amen. You will never sit in loneliness of God if you hear his voice. Hallelujah. But there are anointed non-listeners also. Praise the Lord. The problem is there are anointed non-listeners. Amen. Solomon, himself a man with wisdom, he did not end up listening to the same wisdom. Because no fear, fear of God, all left. Stop listening, all left. And his name was not mentioned in the hall of fame. Hallelujah. Once you used to listen, Pastor, once I listened, praise the Lord. Once you were wise, I would say to you. Hallelujah. He died mad. Some of his last writings, the Bible scholars believe he wrote in his madness, because he was too condemned. He became mad. Condemnation will make you mad. Oh, hallelujah. Some of you, I know you might have made a mistake, but don't live in it. Get out of it and be wise again. Because if you live in condemnation, it'll keep you mad and you will never have freedom in your life and never fulfill the purpose of God. Every person would have made one mistake or the other. Don't self-justify. Come out of it and say, Lord, I need your mercy, and you will be free again. Hallelujah. Are you with me, church? Saul, again an anointed non-listener, did not listen to the point where he glorified God. When you don't listen to God in every single detail, oh, that is an important word. When you listen, you cannot say, I listen like Saul, that I listen. You have to listen to every single detail. Hallelujah. Moses built the tabernacle because he listened to every single detail. That's why the glory came down.
Wow.
As a church, we need to single detail. Ellam sraddicha, ella detailum sraddicha devam parayunna kekkanam. Annale devathinte mahathvam arangullu. Hallelujah. This is getting into your heart tonight. Only then your anointing will glorify God. Hallelujah. Otherwise, you will irritate God.
Look at somebody and say, glorify God and don't irritate God.
Some of us became eternal irritation to God. Praise the Lord. Because you cannot show that to God. The closest person is a pastor. You show it to him. Praise the Lord.
That's why Psalm 21 is written, kept there for us. I lift up my eyes toward the mountain.
You will end up not fulfilling the purpose of God. You will not fulfill the anointing that was upon you. You will not end up
moving or walking into that anointed place where God has kept for you. 1 Samuel 15, 19, 22 and 23 says, obedience is better than sacrifice. If you have never read it, let's read it. 1 Samuel chapter 15, 19, 22 and 23. 19th verse, 22 and 23rd verse.
Why then did you not obey the voice of the Lord? Why did you swoop down on the spoil and do evil in the sight of the Lord? Then Samuel said, has the Lord as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of the Lord? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed than the fat of rams. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's not be stubborn. Amen. Somebody explained this in a beautiful way. I liked it. Somebody said, they end up sacrificing a God-given life when they refuse to listen to Him. Amen. When you don't obey Him, listen to Him, you will end up sacrificing a God-given life. Hallelujah. Look at Jonah. He got into unnecessary storm. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Other day I heard a storm that was supposed to come and hit the Gujarat went to Oman. Praise the Lord. But some people, even when they go to Oman, you will attract, you will catch, no, come, come. Don't disobey God. And connect it to storm that doesn't belong to you. Amen. Are you with me, church, tonight? Hallelujah. The moment Jonah listened to him, he immediately was released. Tonight, some of the storm will become still and leave your lives forever. If all that you need to do is to listen to the law, listen to the voice of God. There is no storm that is powerful than the voice of God. The Bible says the voice of the Lord is over many waters. The voice of the Lord stills the storm. Even tonight, the voice of the Lord is powerful, it's mighty. Hallelujah. Look at the great man Moses himself. He was an anointed non-listener. When God asked him to speak to the rock, he struck the rock. In Malayalam, I written it. Samsarichu theerkanda karyangala adichu theerkalle ennu. I don't know how to put it in English. Things that you should speak, you should not end up fighting or striking. Most of our problems is because that we should have spoken in peace, we are striking at each other. Isn't it amazing? Look at somebody and say, speak to me, don't hit me. In family life, that which should have been spoken, you're striking. This revelation will eternally take fights from your family life. Some of you tonight receiving it, God is giving you a grace to eternally leave fights from your family life. If somebody wants to receive it, praise the Lord. If it's a hobby, praise the Lord, I can't help it. But you want to leave and have a peaceful Rabadiyas Karadaras. Some people said, but still God bless me. That is God's mercy. Amen. Samson, anointed non-listener, he lost. The word lost always belongs to non-listeners. Anytime any kind of loss has come to your life, is because you did not listen to God. Financial laws, marital laws. I've always seen somebody who never listens had always had the loss. But tonight, if you listen to him, everything that you lost through your non-listening ears will come back by faith in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Korah disappeared from his ministry, from this earth. Once a part of God's plan. Once a part of Moses' ministry. Disappeared because he listened to his pride. Balaam, prophet of God. The category changed, the name changed. He's become the prophet of the devil. Once I belonged to God, I spoke for God. Now I'm speaking against God and God's people. Oh, come on, somebody. You're listening to the wrong voice. Isn't it amazing? How many of you know the Lord will never throw you into the open? Just like that. Cain was told by his parents that we heard the serpent's voice and we made a mistake. But when we heard God's voice, God restored us. Abel and Cain were there, but Abel listened. He became a prophet unto God. Cain was deaf. And the serpent in its total force came upon him. He was 7 times worse than Adam and Eve were non-listeners. He fled from the presence of God.
Oh, wow.
When God gave you an opportunity to listen, you did not listen.
Are you here tonight, church? Just lift your hands and just worship the Lord for a few minutes tonight. Oh, ask the Lord to open your ears tonight. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. Just worship the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Open our ears that we will hear you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Open our heart that we'll understand you, Lord. Open, O Lord, tonight our understanding. Open our ears that we'll hear the words of God. If anybody is here tonight, let them hear what the Spirit has to say. Let it enter into their heart and make eternal changes. To glorify the Lord tonight. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray. Amen. Look at the root of non-listeners. The root. Where does it come from? Lucifer. When he lost the fear of God, he was the first anointed non-listener. He lost his worship. Because if you don't worship, you won't listen. That's why we come to worship the Lord. The last few weeks, the extended time of worship is given to you so that you will be listeners. Lydia was a worshiper and God opened her heart to heed what Paul has to speak. She understood what Paul said. Look at Lucifer. He lost his worship. He became proud. Humility is the key through which you open your door of your heart. And every other is door open when you humbly hear his voice. Pride is the key where the non-listeners or anointed non-listeners closes the door where God wants to open.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Tonight, let every Luciferian spirit of pride and non-listening leave our lives tonight. From this church tonight, Father, in the name of the Lord, your Son Jesus tonight, let your people open their heart to hear the voice of God tonight in the blood name of Jesus.
We give you glory and honor tonight in the name of Jesus. And third thing was in the Lucifer was the magnetic demonic association. One third of the angels associated with Lucifer. That's why you should never sit or listen or talk with people, especially on a day when you have not worshipped God. Don't go and associate with wrong, negative people, especially on a day when you have not worshipped God. One third of the law, angels fell with the Lucifer. Never sit with people of the same stories. A day when you have not worshipped the Lord, you'll fall with them. They'll take you down. Hallelujah. Are you with me, church, tonight? Third quality of, I'll go fast tonight, lack of time. Third quality of the midwives were miracle speakers. Everybody said miracle speakers, miracle speakers. You heard there, Pharaoh told them to kill every baby that is a male. And when they did not do it, Pharaoh came in and asked, why you did not do it? And they said, the Israel women are more vigorous. They give birth early. Hallelujah. Some people believe they lied to Pharaoh. I believed because they spoke in faith, it actually happened. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Israeli women, hallelujah, delivered so fast. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. They were lively. God did a miracle according to what they said. Oh, hallelujah. People who stand at the gap are miracle speakers. Hallelujah. People who have the anointing are prophetic miracle speakers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Humbly lay anointing releases miraculous words from your mouth tonight in the name of the Lord. Let miraculous words come through this church. Oh, Ravalavala Sandaradare. Victory by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Number four, they understood the power of unity. These women were the heads of the midwives. And they understood we need to stand united with God, with God's purpose. They stood united together as leaders in the church. Only if you stand united, if husband and wife stand united, God's purpose will be fulfilled. Hallelujah. The head should believe that. Head of the family, the husband. Jesus is the head of the church. He believes in unity. The head of the family is the husband. Husband should believe in unity. The head of the church is the pastor. Pastor, as I am the pastor of the church, believe in love and unity. There were two head midwives. One was Pura. Pura means beauty or brightness. When unity is there, there is so much brightness. The darkness simply leaves. The schemes of darkness that is designated to attack you will leave when, hallelujah, the brightness of God comes. One of the midwives is called beauty. Look at somebody and say, you're beautiful. People who stand at the gap are beautiful. Praise the Lord. When everything goes down, beauty comes up. As a matter of fact, it was the same brightness Lucifer had when he was a worshipper. He was called the bright morning star. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. One of the words, one of the other second midwife's name was Shipra, which means ram's trumpet. Ram's trumpet. She was not afraid of the battle. She was not afraid of what Pharaoh said. She focused on what the Lord said. She had the ram's trumpet, the voice of the lamb. ram's trumpet. Ram in the Bible signifies the Lamb of God, the ram's trumpet, the voice of the Lamb. Come on, somebody, tonight you should have the voice of the Lamb that does not fear any battle. It's been 2,000 years. Jesus has died and rose again. And every intercessor is not afraid. Everyone who stand at the middle are not afraid. Oh, Rabalabala Sandara Durajara Rabas. Are you with me, church? Because of the lack of time. Number five, they were more concerned about others than themselves. They were more concerned about others than themselves. They were not afraid to die. They were more concerned about the Egyptian woman. Amen. Number six. Number six. They brought comfort and healing to the camp. Amen. Hallelujah. They brought comfort and healing to the camp. Are you with me, church, tonight? Are you with me, church, tonight? Number seven. And number eight, we'll discuss it later, sometime, not time. Number seven, they saw the future. They saw the future. Number eight, they did not allow the negative emotions to decide the outcome of their decision. How many of you know when Pharaoh, when there are threats, you go through those emotions and be like, oh, should I quit? Should I keep quiet? Should I change sides? Should I compromise? But they would have gone through those emotions. Bitter. Why is God doing through it? Unforgiving. So many of us have negative emotion, depression. But these people did not allow their decision to decide the outcome of their decision. Did not allow the emotions, the negative emotions, to decide the outcome of their decision. I don't know what you're going through. What you're going through is not a sin. It becomes a sin when you allow your negative emotions to make the outcome of your decision. Hallelujah. Jesus went through Gethsemane and said, if it is possible, he went through the negative emotion, take this cup away from me. But then he did not allow the outcome. He said, not my will, yours be done. Praise the Lord. And what is the blessing? I say this and I'm going to pray for you. What is the blessing to be a midwife? Exodus chapter 1 and the 21st. And I pray with you tonight.
And so it was, because the midwives feared God, that he provided households for them.
Because they feared God, he provided households. Households. Oh. Anybody who stand in the middle and pray will have houses. Hallelujah. We'll have houses. Hallelujah. Avan bav sondamayittu bhavanangal panadu kodukkuna devamana nammadeda. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Devathinu vendi devathinte burden chumakkunavan. Hallelujah. Devam avan outward aayittu parayana sammanamayittu, I will build you houses. I will buy the land. I will build the houses. I will put the husband. I will put the wife. I will put the children. That word means numerous. That word means numerous descendants. Not only a house, descendants to live in that house. Wow. Progeny. Numerous progeny, if my pronunciation is right, which means numerous descendants. Hallelujah. Called miracle houses. Till Moses became 80 years and came back, for the next 80 years These people had houses in the land. Hallelujah. For two generations to live. Come on, somebody, tonight. There is power when you sacrificially pray for some people. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This is called the anointing of the midwives. In Hebrew, it says, Hamli Ale anointing. Let's close our eyes in prayer tonight.